Hello, everyone. Hope you're doing well out there. Have two parts of the update here tonight. First will be our family and community update. Make sure we celebrate the many, many good things that have been going on the past 2 weeks since our last update, and provide a couple other kind of clerical things of what's going on in the district. Then the second part will be our weekly health update, let you know where we are with regional rates as well as district cases, and make decisions for what level of response we'll have heading into next week. So first, we'll start with the celebrations. Lots and lots of great stuff going on. It's wonderful to see our students participating. Again, our three main goals this year are safe, open, and as normal as possible. And we see that each and every day. Appreciate all of our students, our amazing, amazing students, our staff, and you as families all coming together. This doesn't happen. This doesn't continue to happen without everybody's patience, understanding, cooperation, and openness to knowing that, these things, some things take time, some things take kind of working through the problem, and all things take communication. All things take us hitting the pause button on sometimes where our thinking can take us in these stressful kind of times, and providing the space needed to, figure things out for the benefit of all these wonderful, wonderful students that we have here. Really proud of all the work that we're doing. Again, as normal as possible. So can't thank Mr. Peck enough and the Livonia Fire Department for coming up and engaging our students outside and talking about fire safety and showing them the many different things that our fire department does. Really appreciate Mr. Peck for coming up and doing that. As normal as possible is certainly a big part. The 1800 days for our second graders. Again, getting back to some things that we've done, some traditions that we've done for a very long time here. Great to see them participating and learning as we move through it. Field trips, again, we assess each and every week and make determinations on where field trips can happen and how they can happen. This one happened to be at Stokey Farm. So again, it was outdoors. We were able to say, okay, this field trip should be there. So safe, open, and as normal as possible, and lots of great successes already through the year as we move that way. Want to say thank you to our food service staff. One thing we certainly were reminded of when this all started over a year and a half ago is, how essential our food service program is to us, how important it is to meeting our students and our families' needs with ensuring good nutrition is there. They continue to do a tremendous job, just hugely flexible and responsive, and really appreciate them and want to celebrate them as part of National School Lunch Week this week. Also want to celebrate our and recognize that it's Bus Safety Week in our transportation department this week. Again, another critical and sometimes overlooked piece of school is getting here and getting here safely, which over the last couple of years includes the COVID protocols as well as just general transportation safety. So can't thank our bus drivers enough. Tremendous transportation department, dedicated, committed folks to making sure that we keep rolling. We can't again have school without them working as well as they do. And then Board of Education Week this week as well. So another group that often is sometimes overlooked in their importance of how this all goes. Our Board of Education is tremendous. They're stable. They're responsive. They're trusting. They represent our community in such a fine manner and help us move forward safely throughout all this. Without their support, without their guidance, without their oversight and governance, everything else would be much more difficult to do. So really appreciate our board members, and we'll be celebrating them a little bit more formally at our board meeting next week. Some athletic celebrations here. Great here tradition here of celebrating the educators who have impacted our student athletes by presenting them this picture here with the jersey. Senior nights have rolled through, so awesome to have those happen. We had to reschedule one here for a football team that will be this Friday. Great to see our seniors have regular sports seasons and be able to move through all this. boys soccer and volleyball as well. Cross country and girls soccer, again, have already happened, but want to celebrate all of our senior athletes having great seasons, being able to move through this in as a normal as possible fashion as we have there. Special congratulations to Angela for being the 2021 LCAA Senior Swimmer of the Year and Outstanding Performer of the Meet. She came in first place, as it says here. I can celebrate her too, just as being a great swimmer. She's she coaches my two of my kids in the dogfish program, and they just really look up to her and love her, and she's a great student athlete. We have some sectional games coming up. So just a quick reminder here that on Friday the 22nd at 6 down in Bath, we'll have our girls soccer team who won their first game this week and be down there with them. And our boys soccer team will be headed to Batavia on Saturday at 6:30. Want to also point something out on our website. It's a new, we've always had a tip line on our website. We've now moved over to a more robust reporting system for us to maintain and communicate as administrators when these tips come in. So as you can see here, it's going to be on our website. It's just going to say tip line. You can share concerns. People, then, you know, then it comes in. Once you're logged into the app, and you can submit a report, and you can see kind of how the report gets processed, which is the new kind of enhanced feature in all of these things. They're handled by a number of people that we've contracted also with a service who also takes a look at them and helps them helps us respond, as well as our school administrators. So we're looking forward to that enhancement. And again, what are the things that are good to report in the tip line? I mean, there's a whole host of them, but you know, if you need a way to reach out, you're not sure how to reach out, you have a concern about somebody, you have a concern about, you know, something that's going on, please just use the tip line. It gets looked at. This system that we have, again, notifies different administrators if it is, you know, something in some of these cases, as you can see on the screen, we'll notify law enforcement, mental health professionals, and it's all part of our approach here. So we're taking our tip line to kind of the next level. Want to just remind you that it is on the website, and please submit any tips with any kind of concerns or issues that you may have. It's really important. Over our years of having a tip line, it has helped in a number of specific incidents make us aware of something we need to be aware of, and provide the support and engage different families in different ways that we need to. So we appreciate it and want to remind people that it's there. All right, part two of our report is our weekly update with our health status and response level. And so we'll go through that again. Our goals there, you can see that our county still remains in the highest level according to the CDC assessment of it. The Finger Lakes region, the state did change the graphics, so this looks a little bit different, but it's the same information I've highlighted here, that for the Finger Lakes region, the 7-day average for this past week here is 4.7. When I reported it at 10/10/13, it was 4.6. So we're still hovering around the mid fours as a region. In our county, we have 114 cases as I pulled this down today. That was about of noon of today. Looking specifically at our zip codes there, you can see that we have a handful of cases here, 15 cases across our zip codes. Just a reminder too, to keep things in perspective, that still remains to be a pretty small overall percentage of our total population in our zip codes. So it is in our community. We do need to be cautious about it, but we also always want to be sensible about it and put things in context. When you look across the reporting kind of dates that we've been working here, what you can see kind of how we're a little bit lower here in Livonia than we were last week. It was 10 last week, it's 6 this week. Up in Lakeville up to 4, down in Canisius down to 4, And Hemlock is kind of holding started there in the onesie twosies over this time period. These are, again, are for any active cases that are in our zip code of any age. And so it just gives us kind of the local, a little bit of local flavor within Livingston County. So what we do is we take that information, the CDC here, again, we're at a high level, and then we want to look closer each week at what was happening in Livonia Central School District, specific data for percents positive of those people that were in attendance. So we're going to be looking at October 11th through the 17th to make some decisions here and communicate it to you for what we'll be doing next week. So the 11th was a holiday, so that's why there's a lot of zeros there. Looks a little different on the graph, but also it makes sense that then as we came back on the 12th, we had a little bit of a bump as far as reporting because, you know, it took into account what we normally would have maybe on the 11th. So you can see that we have a number of students in the COVID protocol. And again, why is it a little bit higher at the beginning of the week? I think that's, you know, it's a, at that point, it actually was a four-day weekend because we had the conference day on Friday. And so, you know, kind of things gathered there and then got reported as we got back into things. And still have many more negative tests than positive tests as we move through things. Though I will say, as you can see towards the end of the reporting period in the week, we had a few more positive cases than we're used to on any given day. We had three last Friday. And then I would say over the last couple of days, we've had a bit more too. So we're keeping our eyes on things. We're monitoring things really closely, working with each classroom, each sports team, exchanging some emails with some parents on sports teams tonight, and making sure, right, that we're monitoring and staying safe as we possibly can. Overall, though, as far as our process goes and our system, that still has five positive cases in this time frame. And within that, that's a 0.29% of everybody who is here. And again, you can see how, you know, we had more in the COVID protocol a few weeks ago. We're down a little bit lower there. We have a lot of negative tests, but our positive tests here, right, are still pretty consistent with kind of where we were and where we are across the time from September 7th through October 17th. So that puts us at a low level at 0.29%. And so with the high and the low, high at the CDC and the low in our local data, that continues to move forward where we've been over the last number of weeks in this moderate response level. Just a quick reminder, because of the mandates, face coverings are required at all events inside you know, all day through the day. And so this could change when they change the mandates at the state level, but you know, we're still moving forward where we've been since the start of the school year. Again, physical distancing is important. It is part of the contact tracing process. Just want to remind people that, again, 6 feet or more, people will not be considered close contact. So that's what we've been doing in our lunch rooms. That's why it is inconvenient at times to have some of our middle high school students eating, you know, in gyms. But it does help us avoid contact, students being determined a close contact and having to quarantine during that time. In our classrooms, between 3 and 6 feet is where most students are operating with their desks and where they're moving. By wearing masks, they're not going to be considered a close contact. And it's only less than 3 feet for more than 15 minutes there could still be a close contact there. So again, our staff are aware of this. I was talking with a coach today of how to plan locker rooms and bus trips and those type of things. We are doing everything we possibly can to stay safe. Be open though, and being open is, you know, doing our best to make sure that we're open for everybody and that quarantining doesn't happen widespread. It is happening in other districts. It is happening across the state, and we just don't want that here. We want to keep students safe. That's priority number one. But part of being open is, it's just not for the whole school, but being open so that not a lot of students have to be in preventative quarantines based on you know, kind of how DOH has to look at these things. So long, a lot more information. Just want to highlight though, that physical distancing still is recommended, and we're working it into our plans. same thing that we've been doing since the start of the year again for indoor concessions and fundraising. Daily health screenings, again, we're at the same level. And so it's a moderate level. Indoor individual monitoring, please make sure that you're checking temperatures every morning and looking at the symptoms. And if your student, if anybody is got a symptom, please keep them home. Call our nurse, walk through it. Again, communication is really important as we move through all this. Face coverings on buses are required. Again, that's just part of where we're all at. Visitors and volunteers will be essential for education purposes as they've been since the start of the year. Indoor large group gatherings, again, we have normal capacity. We are going to have physical distancing and face covering. So, you know, as that's for volleyball games, that's for other things that we have inside, and we'll continue as we move forward. And outdoor large group, we are at normal capacity. Indoor and outdoor facility use requests, standard procedures, no changes as we move forward because we're still in this moderate level for next week through Halloween there. As always, thank you so much for all of your trust, your confidence, your cooperation, for extending grace, for being patient. We're still in a pandemic. We talked about this at our administrative team meeting just yesterday. As much as we're pushing forward to be as normal as possible, still there is the reality that this is not normal. And we're still working through the many range of emotions, the different policies that we have to go through because we are in a pandemic and COVID-19 is still in our community and still impacts different people different ways, both physically and health-wise, but also emotionally and psychologically. So I can't thank you enough. How we got through last year is how we'll get through this year, which is sticking together, staying focused, and just continuing to work the problems as they present themselves, and know that we are strong enough when we're together to be able to move through those things. So again, thank you very much. Stay healthy and be well, and we'll talk to you at some point in the future.